Water is tricky. You need to choose the right materials. The original bracket didn't fit, so I made changes and designed something completely different. I thought I made it tougher and safer. But how well it worked? Did I choose the right materials? Get ready for some serious maker challenge, because the swimming pool was this. This episode is sponsored by Elegoo. More on that later. Too many 3D printers? Yeah, it happens. So we looked for houses that we could buy. My wife found a beautiful old house with a space for my workshop. And it had a swimming pool. It just needed new lights. I'm kidding. It needed cleaning, tile adhesive. We got creative. And this type of lamp is forbidden now. It needed to be LED. So I bought this set, but I wanted the lamps fully embedded in the original holes. But I have a question for you. Which filament would you use? It will be constantly underwater. It will get some UV light, lots of chlorine, and people play a lot. So, PLA, PETG, ABS, TPU, ASA, something else. Tell me in the comments. So, why I think my design is better? The original mounts were designed for swimming pools without niches, so flat walls. That's okay, and it's not too bulky. But the lights were very exposed, easy to scratch. Also, the mounting brackets were rigid, and it's not impossible for someone to kick the light by accident and break something. And finally, I have a numeric pet peeve with the design. You know, three venting groups, two rows, one screw. It feels unintentional, it lacks a theme. So, when I designed mine, I used three screws, three venting groups with three holes in each, and three clear faces. See? Three, 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 and three. The middle part is very strong and rigid, and for the big screw holes, I used the amazing technique to 3D print bars without supports, as shown by Angus on Maker's Muse. But the brackets in the back, I wanted them to be flexible, to be shock absorbers, so they were printed in TPU. And it works. TPU is great for water. I printed adapters for the pool floor cleaner, and I printed this pump extension tube back when we needed to completely drain the pool. TPU must be printed slow, but if your printer has a direct drive without any Bowden tube, it's very easy to print. The other two parts were printed in PETG, which is much better than PLA for water and UV light. And you need that because, yes, UV light is not really absorbed by just 1 meter of clean water. This part could be printed in any printer, but the front is big, almost 30 centimeters wide, and I had only two printers that could print this, the Neptune 3 Plus and the Neptune 3 Max. So for any project size, Elegoo has a printer for you. You won't need anything bigger than... Oh my god, never mind. Elegoo and All3DP just launched a summer 3D design competition. So, if you designed any 3D model that makes your summer better or happier, a tool, decoration, gadget, it doesn't matter, submit your model. The prizes are great! There will be 32 lucky winners, carefully chosen by the utmost respectful team of... Huh? Am I one of them? A weird list of judges. In the description, there is a link for you to check all the information. Good luck and have fun! So, when the swimming pool was empty, installing the lights was very easy. That was last year. We had a great summer, winter came, then it rained a lot and water got nasty, and now it took like 10 days to recover the water. So, after 1 year, is there any degradation on my parts? Did the layer lines get nasty or slimy? And without emptying the pool, how difficult would it be to replace or repair anything? I guess there is only one way to know. Yeah, 5 days ago the water was not great yet for video. Looks like one of the screws inside is oxidizing, you can see. Now, the light in the shallow part is way easier to work. And I'm impressed that the front panel is spotless clean. We never rubbed it or cleaned it, just chlorine.
So let's take it apart and see.
Have you ever unscrewed things underwater? Being an astronaut has to be fun.
All right. Wow. Looks great, outside at least. Looks fabulous. Well, inside it's kind of green. These were stainless steel. They look incredible. Let me see the rest.
Definitely the Phillips screws were easier than these flat ones. It got very dirty inside, but that's fine. The filtration will clean everything. OG like 3D printed stuff. The only thing that degraded a bit was the rubber glue that I used because I was paranoid and the LEDs were expensive.
I don't know. It's rubber. It might expire one day.
And the TPU looked just the same. Flexible, same color, just perfect.
The front panel, the bracket, all the LEDs, they're still working. And if one day I need to replace it, I can just take this part out, put it out, I can replace everything put together, because this is waterproof. Now I need to put it back.
This little project was the first thing I 3D printed here, far from the city. It was the only way to go forward in this 3D printing YouTube journey.
Moving here, putting my studio there, restoring the swimming pool. The house has so much stuff yet to do. It's an old house. I'm so happy to share this one tiny bit of our story here. Thank you, Elegoo, so much for sponsoring this video. Otherwise, I don't think I would have told it any other way. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, any comments, just in the description, I read everything, I try to answer everything. Thank you for watching, and see you on the next one.